the wind.
Get up those shrouds.
More sail. Full sail.
Crowd on all the sail we have.
All ship incoming, Captain! It's a break! Spanish enjoy! On your mark, Captain!
Keep on the way! She will ram us!
Fire!
Look, Captain, won't play shot there!
Fire! Ready to fire yourself!
Fire! There, sir! Good shot to trip!
Fire! Fatten yourselves!
Thank you. number of merchants roving these waters is 70 the number of military ships.
Aye, easy purchase, but in small doses.
Right. So to lure the Navy out of hiding, it's best to cause a bit of mischief.
Catch a few small fish to attract the big ones.
That's right. So plunder and pillage as you see fit, Captain Kenway.
Bearing hard for cliffs, Captain.
Trim the yards off the wind. Crowd on every inch of sail.
Starboard, Captain. Survivor cast to drift here, Captain.
Sail ho! Military class brig on the horizon!
Good eye, man. Are you ready for this, Kenway? She won't go down without an honest fight.
Who's up for taking that brig, lads? Shout aye! That's a sound I like to hear. Pipe to quarters! All hands to cannons!
Careful around the Navy. They're as likely to ram you as fire a broadside.
Let's test those powder barrels against them, shall we?
Aye, good thinking.
Ah!
That was a rumble, by God. How do we fare?
Fine purchase, no mistake. Now I think it's time to lay low and bribe our way back into secrecy.
Agreed. So how do we get rid of this notoriety we've stirred up?
Money, my boy. A well-placed bribe to the right government official will see the military off your tail.
Right, let's do that. I'll need to meet these good Samaritans at some point.
Smart thinking.
I think we've lost them, sir.
Cliff dead ahead, sir.
Ease off the wind!
Furl the mizzen tops!
I can keep the heat off. For a fee. Lovely. I'll make sure they forget you, friend.
Thank you.
You're a wonder, Kenway. You've a knack for this kind of work.
It ain't work if you love it.
But I ain't doing this forever, lads. Only until I get enough coin to buy some land and influence back home.
Jesus, will you listen to your tripe? Still dreaming on about that strumpet back in England when you could have any better you wanted here and now.
Ah, such lofty goals for you gents. And here I thought I was in the company of scoundrels. Fine purchase today. What's the crew's mood?
All smiles and no teeth. And there's a few talking about meeting with Master Kid to steal from a nearby plantation.
Plantation? That's ambitious.
Profitable too, if we can manage it.
Aye. It's a good idea.
To the armor and up to toe, up you blinders, up the throne. Wait for day, wait for day, wait for day, and we get our pay. Wait for day, wait for day, wait for day, and we get our
straight for Lancer!
Douse all but me!
Council's in! Clue up!
Why, look! It's the bastard son of the late William Kidd. Still a mere boy, and yet, 10 times the demon his father was.
Fancy seeing you here, Kenway. Still looking sleek and mean. Did you steal that costume from a dandy in Havana?
No, sir. I found this on a corpse. One that was walking about and talking shite to my face only moments before.
Huh.
So, what's this I hear about a planned raid on a plantation? Not keeping secrets from me, are you?
Not very well. Every day, schooners packed with sugar sail past, coming from plantations nearby. Most times they stop here, sell off a few crates. There's one man visiting today that'd earn you a fine profit. So if you'd like to rob his plantation, I'll point him out.
I would. Is it a Mr. Beckford that owns this plantation?
That's the man. He owns dozens round these islands. And he's bloody rich.
Just the sort I like to see robbed.
His agent is around here somewhere. Find and follow him, and he'll lead you straight to your prize.
Burford, Manning, to me. We've done with this place.
Aye, sir. What's our course?
We'll return to the plantation and then take stock of our inventory. Good harvest.
You might not talk so loud, sir. This isn't anything like a friendly port, Ken.
Nonsense, man. I had a delightful conversation with a chap just now. We came to quite an understanding.
As you see, sir.
Haul up and unfurl, boys. We're going home.
You! Stop! The look of a man crafting a bold idea. A look I've seen before.
You mark well, Addy.
I've just overheard one of the Beckford's men talking grandly about his plantation and all the cargo he's keeping, and it gave me the idea that I might take these goods off him and sell them off for a better price than he'd ever ask.
Ah, a man of vision. I like this idea.
Let out some sail!
Let's ride this blow!
Round it all on! Douse the royal to us!
Four! Haul up all the things!
Wind. Shorten sail! Get off the squall!
Trim off the wind! seize her!
Hold at it. It's trouble afoot.
I see them.
Every last scrap of duck on the wind! Reef the topsails and gallants! Swim us off the wind!
Get those spars free! Let's see that dock!
Making for us, sir! Think she's a cutter!
This man's Navy. Working for Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantation, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked the plantation, huh?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled? Something else?
Cane juices. The hard process making sugar. Dangerous. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like, toiling on a plantation day and night?
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers, crush the juice from the cane. After making the juice, it was time to boil away the waters from the sugar. This one is made of copper. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin, you stick like birdlime and burn on. Even a terrible scar.
Jesus. The Peter Beckford's people. Do you know them? The Beckfords and their sugar empire.
Aye. The Beckfords and the Draxes. I never worked their plantation, but I knew their names from hearing other men curse them.
But you worked the plantation, no?
A modest one, aye. As a striker in the boiling house.
Boiling house? Was it water they boiled? Something else?
Cane juices. It's a hard process making sugar. Dangerous. Must be why it fetches such a dear price.
What's it like, toiling on a plantation day and night?
Well, with the cane sugar cut and harvested, it's run between two metal rollers and crush the juice from the plant. After collecting the juice, it was time to boil away the waters from the sugar. This we did in patches of copper. Let me tell you, brother, boiling sugar is near the hottest thing on earth. Just a touch on the skin, you stick like birdlime and burn on. Leaving a terrible scar.
Jesus.
Every last scrap of duck on the wind. Down's all but me. Tops, gallants, royals, studs.
Reef the men. Crew up gallants. Wind is shaping up for a big blow, sir.
Haul them in. Get off the wind.
It's a risk to anchor too close. The soldiers roving the plantation would catch us for sure.
Drop here then and sneak ashore. We'll look after the jackal.
Oh, Why such disarray?
Bit of a do, sir, that's all. It's Wilmington's birthday.
And you saw fit to get pickled on duty?
Don't bother, sir. We have everything sorted.
We'll soon see, won't we? For you must double the watch this evening.
Double, sir? Whatever for?
I believe I was followed by pirates, if my eyes on me, though the ship was uncommonly large. Certainly wasn't slavers, though. Not a ship that size. In any case, double the watch. And keep your damned eyes wide for anything suspicious. You up there! Look alive, man! You've a job to do!
Apologies, sir. I'll keep my eyes peeled.
For God's sake, what the hell is going on here today? How do you suppose you'll be able to ring that alarm if you're pissed drunk and barely able to stand?
Forgive me, sir. I am fit and able. If I see any strangeness about, you'll hear the bell ringing straight away, I promise.
Speak to the man in charge here. I require entrance to the warehouse. Which of you dogs has the key to the warehouse, huh?
Snails.
Faster. Is there no one so near here? Set me the warehouse key, if you please. The key, goddammit! Someone find me the key!
Make haste. We've another load after this.
Hold there. Alarm! Help me, damn it!
Don't leave till it's done. To move on. I didn't hire snails. Careful with that, you dullard.
The gunner will have your head.
Got a clear shot, mate. My sight's clear as day.
You get back here.
Come on.
You can't get past.
shot.
Just have to pull the trigger.
Hurry up,
man. Shoot to the police.
He's trying to give us the slip.
Stand up! Let's get moving!
Fall aloft! Burn your seats!
To larboard, sir! Human flotsam, Captain! Think he's breathing!
Here's to our pirate republic, lads. We're prosperous, free, and out of the reach of kings, clergy, and debt collectors.
Near 500 men now pledge their allegiance to the Brethren of the Coast in Nassau. Not a bad number.
True. Yet we lack sturdy defenses. If the king were to attack the town, he'd trample us.
Then let us find the observatory. If it does what these Templars claim, we'll be unbeatable.
Not that twaddle again, can we? It's a story for schoolboys. I mean, proper defenses. Steal a galleon, shift all the guns to one side. Would make a nice ornament for one of our harbors.
It will not be easy to steal a full Spanish galleon. Have you one in mind?
I do, sir. And I'll show you. She's a fussock, she is. Fat and slow.
Jackdaw handles knives. Pinched her from the Spanish, was it?
Aye. In the midst of a hurricane.
Just before the treasure fleet was smashed against the shore.
Was the haul aboard as rich as men are saying?
A thousand times that. I reckon £1 million worth of reals was sunk that day.
Devil, love a hurricane. We have a dive there one day. See what we can rummage up.
Diving them wrecks would be a nice change of pace for us. No need for violent actions against merchants and such.
Well, that's some soft talk coming from a pirate. And as it happens, I must agree. We'll save the clashing of cutlasses for the military. And them that get in our way.
Our force patrol these waters closely, Captain. Not far now, Captain.
Easy as she goes. No telling what you may find out here.
Like staring through a waterfall.
Don't soil your breeches, lads. I got this.
men!
Loose all and trims out to the wind.
Loose tops and royals. Should be nearby, Captain.
Douse the gallants and royals!
That ship's a monster. Look at the size of her.
Aye. And we'd not last long face to face with her. Hear that, Kenway? Keep your distance. We'll strike when fortune favors us.
And the cover of darkness, most likely.
Aye, it may cover that.
Stairs, we trim too. take it! I know she's a good sailor! Now prove it, my trump!
Douse the royals at the top!
Tonsils in! Clue up!
Charles. Reckless as they come.
An old friend of yours?
Not a man I call a friend. But we've been doing this kind of work for so long, I can't help but...
Need a drink?
Fancy a wee slip?
Fire!
Sailing for that island.
I know the place. A natural stronghold used by a French captain named Ducasse.
Julian Ducasse, the Templar.
Name's right. Didn't know he had a title.
I know the man. And if he sees my ship, he'll know it from his time in Havana, meaning he may wonder at who's sailing her now. I can't risk that.
And I don't want to lose that galleon. Let's think on it. Maybe wait till it's dark before hopping aboard.
Captain has the helm.
Unfurl, mates! Let's move!
Here and pour out in the street and wait for them.
inch of sail.
Close down! Man your sheets!
Gentlemen, as is custom among our kind, we do not plunge headlong into folly on the orders of a single madman, but act according to our own collective madness. The object of our attention is a square-rigged galleon, and we want her for the advantage she'll bring Nassau. So I'll put it to the vote. All those in favor of storming this cove and taking this ship, stomp and shout aye!
Aye!
Those who oppose, whimper nay!
Never was the King's Council so unified.
Ah!
No,